Hello, good morning. So I'm Anvesh from St. Martin's Engineering College, dealing with the foundation engineering. So I'm going to tell you about what is an introduction to the foundation engineering. Okay? And also I'll tell you what are the steps that involves in the foundation engineering. So to determine the economical foundation. Foundation engineering. So what you are going to do is, in the foundation engineering, that you are going to select or determine economical foundation. Okay, so we are having a number of foundations, right? Shallow foundations. Shallow foundations and deep foundations. Okay, so we are having two types of foundations: shallow foundations and deep foundations. So shallow foundations is nothing but you are going to go foundations of a smaller depths. Okay, so this is the ground level. So you are going to construct the foundation just to smaller depths. So that is meant by shallow foundations. And if you are going to install a foundation with a greater depth, okay, so this is example. So five foundation, okay, so pile foundation. So this is the ground level, okay. So here the depth is very high, right? So let's say D1 and D2. So D2 is always more than D1. Okay, so that means the depth we are going to add up in the deeper foundation will always be more. Okay, so these are the two type of foundations basically we are going to add up while constructing any type of structures. Okay, so to find out any structures means to construct any structures. So what type of structures? It may be a building, okay, so it may be a dams or reservoirs, okay, and it may be roads, okay. So take any structure, consider any structure, okay, so it may be a bridges. So it may be any kind of structures. Basically what we have to do is that we have to give a foundation, right? So foundation is a structure which is going to transfer all the loads, right? So which is going to transfer all the loads, that is, let me be a cube, okay? So this load have to be transferred to the ground, okay? So to the ground, all these loads is going to be transferred. So to withstand all those loads, okay, so all those loads, which is the Q, right, all the Q that is going from the foundation to the ground, right, so that loads have to be taken by the ground, okay, by the ground, earth, or else you can call it as subsoil. Okay? Subsoil or substrata. Right? So all those loads is going to be taken by the subsoils. Right? So is it a safe or not? So that will be basically depend on the physical properties of soils. That means subsoil or the ground. Okay, so whatever the strata, whatever the soil strata that is present beneath the foundation, okay, so that is present beneath the foundations, so all the properties, the physical properties, have to be considered I mean, all these physical properties will act as a crucial role in determining the economical foundation, and also to find out whether the load that is coming from the structure, it may be a smaller structure, it may be a bigger structure. Okay, so all those loads, whether the soil strata or like it may be a rock strata. Okay, so whether it may be a soil strata, whether it may be a rock strata, so all the physical properties governs the load. Okay, so whether the ground or the subsoil is stable to take all those loads or not. So what we have to what is that we are needing? First one is physical properties. Okay, so physical properties, and also physical properties, it may be a soil, it may be a rock. Okay, so let it may be anything that is beneath the foundation. Okay, so that is beneath the foundation. Physical properties, okay, and also it is not that the ground or the subsoil is homogeneous. Okay, so it is always a non-homogeneous. Okay, so mostly it will be a non-homogeneous under the foundation. Okay, so if it is a homogeneous, means if the soil or the strata it is of same properties or the same materials, then you can happily adopt a foundation which is calculated previously. Okay, so that means maybe a structure that is beside your site. Okay, so you can collect the information, you can adopt the foundation that you have, that they have considered. Okay, so what is the thing we have to need? We have to know the physical properties, and to determine the layers. Okay, so determine the layers. So the ground may be consists of many layers, right? So this may be a ground level. So ground level. Okay, so the ground may be consists of number of layers. Okay, so each layer may be consists of different type of soils or different type of rocks, or it may be a mixture of rocks and soil, soil and rock stratas. Okay, so it may be a soil, maybe a rock, or it may be soil. Right, so it can be a mixture of the layers, or it can be a same layer. Okay, it may be soil everywhere, but the thing is that we are having different types of soils also there. Okay, so based on the size of the grains, based on their properties like poison ratios, void ratios, relative densities. Okay, so based on those properties, we are going to identify what type of strata it is. Okay, so what type of soil that is present in the particular layer, we can find out based on all those physical properties. Right, so when you find out the type, okay, so when you find out the type of a soil, you will know, or you can estimate how much load that soil can take. The load which is taken by the soil, we call it as bearing capacity. Okay, so that means bearing capacity is nothing but the load that is taken by the ground that is beneath the foundation. Okay, so it may be a foundation, all those loads Q. Okay, so the bearing capacity of soil, so that also is required for us to select different types of foundations or the economical foundations. Right, so to find out the properties, and based on the properties we are going to find out type of the soils that is there. Okay, so based on the properties we are going to find out types of soils, Okay, so that means we are going to classify the soils, or we can classify the strata. Right? So after finding out that type of soil, so we know that how much load it can bear and what type of foundation we can adopt based on the types of the soils or based on the type of the strata. So we are going to adopt type of foundation. Right? So this will be the steps. Right? So first thing is first, we have to know the properties of the ground. Right? So how you can know? So you have to do the site investigation. Right? So first you have to do the site investigation. So first you are going to do the site investigation. What you are going to find out in the site investigation? So you enter site. So when you enter the site and you can find, you can collect all the informations. That means the informations like the ground type. Okay? So your site, what type of ground it is, that means the top layer. Okay? So this is the ground level, right? So this will be the ground level. So at the ground level, what type of rock, or is it a rock, is it a soil strata, what type of strata it is there, you can easily find it when you go to the site, right? So you'll find out. And what else you can get the information? So information from the neighboring structures. Okay, so there may be a presence of neighboring structures around your site, right? So you can collect the information of the ground. So information about the soil reserves. So you are going to collect the information about the soil reserves from the neighboring structures, right? And you can also know the information if how much far you can go for excavations. Okay? So how much you can excavate. So that also you will know when you know the soil conditions, okay, and by knowing the distance from outside of the neighboring building or the neighboring structures. Okay? And also what you can learn? So you can go and learn about some of the groundwater table. Okay? So you can know the information about the groundwater table by observing the borewells. Okay? Borewells that is present at next location, that is the neighboring locations. Okay, so you can go to the neighbors and you can observe the level of groundwater table from their existing wells. Okay, so you can find out the groundwater table, you can find out the information of the soil reserves, that is the physical properties. Okay, so you will know the physical properties. And also what the thing is that you have to, from the information from this, you will be knowing bearing capacity. Okay, and also you can find out different stratas. Okay, so different types. Okay, so different types of soils also, or ground, you can find it, okay, from the site investigation. So this is the first step. So you're going to site and you're going to find out the informations. Okay, so that is, we call it as reconnaissance. Okay, so that means visual inspection. Okay, so that is visual inspection. You are going to the site and through your eyes, what you are seeing, so that information, collection of those information, we call it as reconnaissance. Okay, and then to do and to obtain all those physical properties, what we have to do, we have to collect all the samples or the ground ground samples, right? So you're going to collect the sample, okay? That means it is a ground level. So you're going to dig some amount of earth, the strata, and you'll find out the properties of the soil that is present in here, okay? So you can find out the physical properties, and after digging, what you can find? You can find if there is any presence of layers, okay? So layers also you can find, right? So when you find out this, you can easily predict the type of the soils, and that means the classification of the soils and the bearing capacity of the soils, present soils, right? And by knowing that, you can get the main factor, that is economical foundation. So first technique is boring. So we are going to adopt the boring technique, right? So we are going to adopt the boring technique by adopting the instruments or the equipments for the collection of the samples. Okay. So we have auger boring. Okay. Shell boring. Wash boring. Rotary drilling, you can call it as drilling, and percussion drilling, right? So these are the different types of boring techniques or boring equipments that you are going to adopt in digging the soil strata. Okay, so you are going to dig a borehole so that you can collect the samples from the ground, so that will help you in identifying or determining or conducting the experiments, okay, lab experiments. So you can use those samples to conduct any lab experiments, or you can directly get the information from the visual, directly at the site, okay. And also we have to know how much depth we can go, right? So how much boring depth we can go. So based on the type of structure and based on the number of floors of any building, floors of buildings, okay. So based on the type of structures, based on the number of floors, we are going to find out, and also based on the types of the foundations also, okay. So based on the type of foundations that we want to adopt for the construction, okay. So based on those three factors, we are going to determine the depth of the boring, right. So let's say there is a person whom we call it as sower and sower. So he gave us some assumptions for us to go for the depth. Okay? So depth of boring. Right? So what he said that based on the number of floors. Okay? So based on the number of floors, he gave the depth, assuming the width of the building, okay, assuming the width of the building as 30 meters. So if the width of the building is 30 meters based on the number of floors, if you are adopting one number of floor, okay, then you can go for 6.5 meters, right? So if it is 2, you can go for 10 meters, right? So likewise, so for number of floors, he gave different depths. Okay. So if it is any important structure, okay. So if it is important structures like hospitals, schools, or multi-story buildings, okay. So he gave us the depth of a boring as 3 times of S power 0.7 if we are adopting light steels. Okay, so if you are adopting light steel and concretes, so that means light amount of structures, then you can go for 3 times of S power 0.7. If you are adopting heavy steel or heavy structures, heavy concrete, so if you are taking heavy concrete works and heavy steel works, you can go for 6 times S power 0.7. So based on this formula, you can go and find out the depth of the boring. So how many numbers you are going to do? Okay, so that means how many number of borings you can adopt in a site. Okay, so if it is a just a one story building, okay, so one story building or small structures, you can go for just one number of boring that can be adopted at the center of the site. Okay, and if it is a important structure, if it is a huge or multi story building, you can go for total number of 5 borings. Okay, so that means you can adopt the 5 borings, one at the center of the site and the remaining 4 at the corners of the site. Okay, if it is multi story. Okay, so if it is multi story building, you can go for 5 number of borings. So that's how you can go and do the boring works, okay, and you are collecting the samples. That means it is a disturb, right? So you are going to disturb the ground by collecting the samples, by adopting all those boring techniques or the drilling techniques, right? But you are having total 3 methods which you can adopt in doing the soil exploration. Okay, so you can adopt 3 methods for 3 methods of soil exploration. First one is direct method, okay, and semi direct method and indirect method. Okay, so in direct method you can directly go and dig a pit. Okay, so you can call it as testing pit. Okay, so you can call it as a testing pit, right? Or else you can call it as trench. That means you are just going to dig some amount of soil directly with the excavators. Okay, and in semi direct, you are going to adopt the boring technique, which we have discussed now. Okay, so different boring techniques I have told you. So we are going to adopt those techniques, and we are going to collect the samples to a certain depth with a less amount of diameter than the trenches. Okay, and then the third method is the indirect method. That means you are not going to disturb the ground strata. Okay, so geophysical method, we call it as geophysical method. That means it is electrical resistivity method. Okay, so electrical resistivity method, or else you can go for seismic method. Okay, so these are the methods, geophysical methods, which you are going to adopt in determining the types of the soils and the presence of the groundwater level. Okay, so if it is a ground, you can construct, you can do the indirect methods, and you can find out number of layers by sending the electric signals or the magnetic signals or the seismic signals. Okay, so electric waves, magnetic waves, seismic waves, so using those you can directly determine if there is any presence of number of layers, or if the ground strata consists of only single strata without any layers. So those things and the information about the presence of any groundwater table. Okay, So the presence of any groundwater table, if it is there, you can also find out without disturbing or without digging the ground or the subsoil using the indirect methods. Right? So these are the methods in the soil exploration. Right? So basically, the soil exploration, why we are going to adopt this technique is to find out the physical properties and to find out the types of, if there is any presence of number of layers, and to determine the bearing capacity of the soils, right, by assuming the properties of the soils that is present in the ground.